for tuning in to a new episode of Reagan Fox Talks. Before I get to the meat and potatoes of this episode, I want to remind you, if you haven't done so already, please subscribe to my channel. Please, I'm lonely. Help me, I'm poor.
Help me, I'm poor.
Now, if you like what you hear, make sure you click on the like button wherever it is located and share the video as if it were syphilis or coronavirus. Do not socially distance my YouTube videos. On today's episode, I'm going to provide a few tips that may help you get cast on a reality show. 10 years ago, I was on the CBS reality show Big Brother.
Count your friends in the house. Done already? Why don't you get us a drink, waitress?
And since doing the show, one of the most common questions that I'm asked by strangers is whether or not I have tips on how they too can be cast on a reality show. Typically, my response is really generic. I say, just go in and be yourself. But that's not really helpful advice. Who else are you supposed to? Oh, just be myself. Okay, I'm just going to go in and be myself. And that's not helpful. The first tip is know what makes yourself unique.
Can sacrifice your sacro, working in the back row, bump and a dump till you're dead. Kid, you gotta get a gimmick if you wanna get ahead.
When I went in for casting, I revealed that I was a university professor. And the thing about reality shows is that they're inundated with cast members who are models and Instagram influencers, try my new water, and restaurant workers and cocktail servers. So they're constantly on the lookout for people who have unique hobbies or professions that have never been featured on the show. Tip number two. Don't just tell the producers who you are. You have to show them through the use of story. If they ask you about yourself and you say, I'm funny, but then you don't back it up with a story, they don't care. They don't care. They don't care. They don't believe you. They think you're a liar. They just think you're a stupid lying bitch. So what you need to do is you need stories that illustrate how you are, the adjectives you use to describe yourself. Instead of saying, hi, my name's Reagan, and I like drama, I'm just real drama, I'll bring so much drama to the show. They want to hear how you bring drama in your day-to-day life. So you might say something like, I was at the movie theater the other day, and I'm one of those people who is super sensitive to sound. Like, it drives me crazy when I'm in the movie theater and people are chewing on ice or rattling their popcorn bag. I can't let go of it. And I was sitting next to a family. They brought in pistachio nuts. So every couple of seconds, a different family member was cracking open their pistachio nut during the movie, and I got up out of my seat and went up to them and I said, you're all going to hell. My third piece of advice is you need to rehearse your anecdotes. Say that you're somebody like me. I have a tendency to ramble. That's why in my YouTube videos you see so many different jump cuts. The final round of casting for Big Brother happens over the course of a week, and everybody is stuck in a hotel that week. And I spent my downtime in the hotel making a list of different little stories that I might share during my casting interviews. They would ask me a question. I knew from my previous tip that I wanted to show and not just tell them who I was, but I didn't want to ramble. So I would start off with a story that, when I was first telling it in my hotel room, might have been 7 or 8 minutes long. And by rehearsing it over and over and over again, I began to whittle it down, and I would get the story down to about 3 minutes and only share the most entertaining, impactful, lively parts of the story. You definitely don't want to be the drunk girl at the party who's just rambling on and on and on. Yeah, I was trying to get into the bathroom and there was somebody there, but I also want to talk politics right now. It's like, what is going on with this election? It's like COVID. Like, who wants to wear a mask? Is that even fashion? My fourth and final piece of advice is to be prepared to talk about the other people who are going through the audition process. They're looking for people who are going to be really great and funny and quick in confessional segments. So I literally had a pad and a pen and started taking notes on everybody who was in my dining group or other people who were sitting on the couch next to me. And I came loaded and ready to read them to filth. Reading is fundamental. I developed nicknames for them. There was one woman who had a spray tan. And you know when people get a spray tan, but they put something over their eyes so their eyes are white, but the rest of their body is dark. So I called her Reverse Panda, right? So, and I had things to say about Reverse Panda. Another thing that's really good is try to develop catchphrases when you're reading people. Rachel from my season of Big Brother is the queen of catchphrases.
Flirters, you better grab a life vest.
You try to come in between me and my man. You try to break up me and my man. Ain't nobody gonna get between me and my man, Andrew, and especially not another man. Ew.
And that's what they're looking for. They're looking for that entertainment factor because the audience loves stuff like that. Think about what you enjoy when you're watching a TV show and try to bring that to your audition. If you have any more questions about the reality TV show casting experience, that makes it sound like a ride at Universal, experience ride me, feel the experience. If you have questions, go into the comment section and ask me. I'm an open book. I'll answer whatever questions you might have. I'm so lonely during the pandemic. It'll give me something to do. Until next time, my friends, remember, like, share, and subscribe.